Welcome to another Foolish Kitchen Outdoors, and we're still eating mussels. It's mussel season here in Maine, which will be pretty much our season, and anytime is good for mussels. These are Bang Island mussels. In Maine, everything, I'm not sure, everywhere else it probably does too, but everything comes with a tag. They are harvested by a fellow named Matthew Moretti. Yesterday, 10 a.m., on Chabig. So basically, that's how fresh they are, and I got them over at Harbor Fish. So now I'm gonna go put some water in here from the hose faucet, and I'll come right back. Those are the neighbor's dogs, not my dog. Bang Island are reputedly and proven to be fatter, and unlike the PEI ones, they're not cleaned. They have, because they're so fresh, they have their little feet, but they're like, Chabig is in Portland Harbor. Nice little island. So we're gonna put these in the pot. Get out. Your dog is want. She wants some. It's on. I can just barely see it. Okay. And in the pot with our little buddies, I still have some lemongrass. So I'm gonna put that in too. It's getting drier. Just bought it. I bought it like for the last time, just like, you know. So, but we really just want the flavor. Don't ask me why we don't use lemon. I just had it in an Asian restaurant with lemongrass, and I just thought that was the bee's knees. Okay, so that's gonna be. It's gonna be a busy pot because I've got stuff to put in here that had nowhere else to go anyway. So lemongrass is kind of like a. Like a bamboo. There's all these different layers. I mean, the dry parts are probably not good. They're not as pungent, and in the time we've got, it's not gonna do much. Save that for something else. And definitely gotta put my garlic in there. I didn't bring out another butane tank, so hopefully it won't run out. I mean, there's no point in peeling it. What the heck? And while we're doing this, I'm going to hopefully open up some clams for myself and not kill myself on camera, because I hurt. I mean, I do it fine. I just doing it while people are watching. These are tops of some of the greens that were bolting in the yard, so I think this is some parsley and some cutting celery and some cilantro. I know I'm one of those people who likes it, but I just had to tear those tops off and feel like throwing them away. It wasn't enough to dry. So basically, we're just going to put that in there too. All flavors are good. Oh, I think this is some dill. So that's going to sweat in your pot while that's cooking. And hopefully this whole thing is, this is supposed to be in focus, so hopefully it is. I still have a garlic left. Yeah, I know, I'm from New England. There's no R in garlic. Oh, good grief. Got the white wine. Look. It's got a cup, half a cup or something. Just enough. Yep, it's wine. It's still percolating just fine. So these, I didn't read the label on these, where they were from, but I'm guaranteed they're local. So I put some ice in here in the billy can with them. Hopefully we'll have convinced them to open up for us. Because I've got these ready and waiting for you. We'll get one of them opened at least. And I don't do this all the time, so I'm pretty good at it over the sink. And I brace it up against the thumb. And I didn't clean these either, so I'm not squeamish about dirt, so. And this is a really good, this is Morty the Knife Man. High carbon stainless. This is has the textured handle. This is what the clamors will use. I have another one that was supposedly expensive, and the handle is just too slow. 90. I had the wrong end on my hand. Oh, I am so editing that out. I think I should have washed these. A little sand. If you put them in cold water, basically if you're buying them in a... Oh, I should have put a windbreak. If you're buying them in a place that has them, in a tank or something, or in a... What they will do is when they... Not a tank, I'm saying. And they go out and collect them, farm them, whatever. They put them in these... what do you call them? The clam... pens, and they change the water. It's fresh water or fresher water, and they change it. They try to wait, and they don't. They want them to expel their sand, but when you get them here, they don't have sand. Then you're not sure they're fresh. And essentially, this is the kind of thing you do. No plate, no fork. You do it with a knife sitting on the back of your back of the car. That is delicious. I found the cover for the blue speckleware. I didn't want to do this, I just wanted to. I almost thought about having a New England crab bake. Bring a big pot out with lobster and some steamers. I like mussels better. Next time we'll do that. I actually have some corn. Oh, we got little... I think there's some barnacles on there somewhere. Change out the butane. One steamed pot. Smells good. I mean, they really only take a few minutes to cook anyway. Just want the hot, the herbs that I threw in there to kind of infuse. I've had plenty by themselves. I don't kind of ruin them by dipping them in butter. I mean, I think that was a wonderful memory. Child just did not do all that damage. I know I'm jealous of all those people at the restaurants who do this all day long. Not, I mean, it's unpleasant and their hands chafe. And I'm sure at the end of the day they really don't like them, but they just do it so well. Keep as much of the liquor in the clam. You'll lose some. But try to keep as much so it's get the slurp value. I know, you watch the people making the oyster duck, cutting the oysters. And those oysters have been, sand. That's okay. Well, dirt's good for you. Oh, is that just as close to adjusted recently? That's fine. I'm a happy girl. And by the time I get to the other ones, they'll think, oh, she's gone. I just found a bunch of oysters. I had plenty. I just really like things like little necks, cherry stones, quahogs. I don't care, I'll eat them. But it's harder to get find restaurants that have them on offer. Find a good raw bar. And even in Maine, I mean, everybody's, you know, tourists all want oysters. It's kind of foolish, and then they want things steamed. You can find some place that actually has, you know, raw. I'm like, oh, yeah, exciting. I know that must sound terrible, but I'm pretty. That's a different neighbor's dog. I don't sit up behind the house that often. I wish I might put her in the garden. Not put it back in the house. I'd be surprised. It's usually way more bugs than there are right now. So, it's this part that's on the thumb. I'm gonna cut out that other part so it's not so embarrassing. And this other part, they have names. I don't remember the anatomy. I do remember that I have to get started because I'm not strong enough to force it. Yeah, I'll put a trigger warning for anybody who doesn't want to see bivalves die. It's not my fault. He was dead when they collected him. And just, he was slated to die. I'm not quick, I'm not fast, I'm just really careful. You have to loosen what's attached. Otherwise, it ends up going all down your chin and then you look like a doofus. Sand in my teeth. Long shell. Tastes like the ocean. Ah. There's a smell. One more shot. I will save him for dessert. Oh, he's gonna get eaten. Down in the garden? Look at that dog. Dang, it's all sticky now. That's part of the fun. As soon as I can use that shell over again. I'll use this one for the shellies. Sounds. Hope it doesn't steam up. I'm trying not to get any on the table, and then it will attract bugs after I go back to my house. Greens come out because they're gonna just make it be harder to pull. Yeah, we'll do a clam bake next time. I'm not really mad about steamers, but just for you. Last time I made ramen with the broth, and it was terrific. Okay. No. I'm gonna get you anyway. Yeah, they are. The Bang Island ones are much bigger. I know a couple places I can get them. I just don't think that they need butter. If I want butter, I can just bite some butter. If they're good, you don't need it. It's like lobsters. I almost rarely will use drawn butter. And I think that that's just an excuse for butters that are lobsters that are less than stellar. I'm sure you really don't want me to. I should have pulled that off when I was blind. I'm sure you really don't want me to sit here and eat these. I can. You know, people like that kind of thing. No. It's a trick I learned from people who are squeamish. You take the butterfly like that, and you do this. Ta-da! It's not perfect. Well, I'll use that one. Oh, this is a beautiful day for this. But I have a hell of anatomy. Taste the garlic, I taste the herbs. A lot of it, I think, is for the nose. I might possibly do something with broth after I know what I'll do. Maybe I'll make it. Oh, brilliant idea! I was gonna make a haddock chowder, fish chowder. I'll use that broth. Just gotta make sure. Sand stays in the bottom. At least not long enough. I know. I think this is supposed to feed two people. What do I know?
Oh, with the spring. Beautiful. And you, oh, I really want one of those wreaths that they make with these, not for the door. They make them look like flowers. It's very pretty. Oh, that one pops ahead. I'm gonna eat them while they're still warm, because it's cool. Going off out here. And water the garden. And go inside and wash all this ocean off my fingers. My dog wants some. She's not gonna eat it. I don't want to waste it. That's your food. Nope. Saw that coming. And if you do have leftovers, that's okay. Take them out of the shells. Put them in some butter, like melt some butter, bury them in the butter. And then, so you don't want it to dry out. And then put them in a nice spaghetti sauce. And do a fra diavolo with peppers and stuff. Oh wait, don't waste them. It's because you cooked them. Thank you for joining me for my picnic.